Welcome back, guys. It's Kasket here again. We are just I'm back. We're going to be casting the next game here of the Balt Cup. Looks like we are pretty much just double check the stages. Looks like we already had all games done. So I mean, we have Frankie versus OP is what they're calling themselves, Ogre Powered, and Team Atlas versus Hunters. I'll be casting one of those games. Depends on which one they want me to. Oh. Just give me some time. We're going to talk some things over. Looks like I can either co-comment or I can do whatever for these next games, because we are going to have two more games and then basically the finals, because we did start with 8-4-2, so we only have the finals left. So we'll just listen to some good music while we're discussing things, and hopefully we'll get things going for you guys. I might, if I do co-cast with Mike, I'll drop my stream just so I could focus on co-casting with him, so not a big problem there. So just for the time being, just bear with us as we get things going. Team Atlas and Hunters. Okay, guys, looks like I'm gonna try to get into the Team Atlas Hunters game and start casting that one real quick. Let's see if I can just find somebody from the teams. Okay, guys, looks like we are getting into the next game. It looks like it's underway. I'm going to be streaming that one, so let's turn off the music here really quick. Oh, it doesn't want me in. Come on, let me in. Just bear with me really quick, see if I can't get into this game. This game will be between, I'll be able to tell you in just a second. Looks like this is between Team Atlas and Hunters. I got in a little late, so I won't be able to do the draft. But we can run through real quick the team. So on Atlas, they are on the Dire side. Looks like we will have, or actually, excuse me, they are on the Radiant side, and looks like they're already all jumped up into the jungle here. Let's just fix some things real quick. Free camera, yay. So, yeah. Sorry if they got these games going really fast. So, Atlas here is, we have IQ before on the Bounty Hunter. We have a dual lane mid. We have the Rubick. Lawn is on the Rubick. We have Chimichi on the Dragon Knight. Yeah, this guy on the Luna, I don't even know how to say his name. It's not even a name. And we have Noiza MC on the Sand King. So, and then we have four Team Hunters. We have the Clockwork is being played by Finneth. We have Relic, who is taking up the Troll Warlord. And we have King Last Hit Magic, the Legend, on the Enchantress. And then we have Eosin. I don't know if that's the real Eosin. I bet it's just a copy. He is on the Lich. And we have Fan of Soyin on the Quap. Oh, and already missing first blood. It looks like the first blood actually happened on this mid lane, and it looks like he might be able to get a second kill. Can he do it? No, a stun comes out from the Dragonite on the Relic and being picked up and thrown back in town. Tyridge, he does take one more damage. Is he going to fall? He does fall. The Troll Warlord does fall, but in the end, he is able to pick up the Dragon Knight. Well, the Dragon Knight does go down, but it looks like the first blood came out from the Enchantress being able to pick off this Rubick. Her creep actually did it. The Troll Warlord did all the work, but the Enchantress creep was able to pick up the last hit. And so we've already had three kills happen in this middle lane. Pretty crazy stuff already. Again, apologies guys for coming into this game late. It was kind of last minute to get into it. Oh, and on the top lane, looks like the Bounty Hunter is not able to get away from this Queen of Pain, who has an amazing set here. Pretty slick Maze of Anguish, uncommon wings. That's pretty cool. So yeah, it looks like the Bounty Hunter was picked off here by that Queen of Pain. Not sure exactly how that happened. Oh, I guess they do have a Sentry Ward placed here, so the... No, that's a Radiant place Sentry Ward, so he's actually being able to see what happens. See, you can kind of see the new meta with this whole taking the creep. See how he's gaining the experience, and these guys aren't gaining as much experience. So the Bounty Hunter, even though he's just kind of chilling here, not doing really anything, he is able to pick up the creeps, and he does get a last hit on one of them, so he is able to pick up some much-needed gold there. But like I said, pretty interesting how it's able to just gain experience for nothing. Looks like we do have a little bit of an engagement, not really much. Lucent Beam, I guess I should, yeah, Lucent Beam being thrown out on the clockwork just kind of doing some harassment. Nothing too crazy here on the bottom lane. Looks like he's going to come over here and try to maybe see what's going on there. Nothing too much is going on there, just kind of some trades back and forth now. Things have kind of settled down. Nothing too crazy here for Team Atlas or for Hunters, just kind of things going on, but you know, never know. Like I said, that's twice I missed first blood in the first game, missed first blood in the second game. Man, I was hoping I would actually catch one of them. Definitely need to hone up on my casting skills to do a little bit better job on that one. We have the Enchantress here just kind of chilling away, taking some creeps from the Radiant jungle, doing the best that she can, denying farm here, because you know, we'll have to see what happens here on Team Atlas and how they want to try to counteract this. They have the Sand King coming up here, but I don't think much is going to happen to that. So right now, kind of a passive game. Nothing much going on.
Heard of me?
Just kind of plugging along. Again, let's see, nothing really happened. The Enchantress is just kind of chilling right here, doing, you know, minding her own business. I do hear a Whirling Axes being gone out, and this Enchantress with her Wildwing Ripper throwing out this Tornado. Just general harassment here, helping out Mr. Troll Warlord here on the Mr. Relic here on the Troll Warlord, excuse me. Man, can't talk today. Sorry, guys. Doing, you know, just plugging along. Definitely. Oh, and again, sorry guys, I missed it. The Queen of Pain just dove on the Bounty Hunter. It looks like they threw out some smoke that the Lich was carrying. I would assume that the Lich was carrying it, and they were able to pick up this Bounty Hunter again. This Bounty Hunter has not been very effective as a... been definitely being picked off a couple times. You know, hopefully they can kind of turn that around, because looks like Atlas is definitely on the back foot already. The Bounty Hunter's gone down twice to this Queen of Pain. The mid already had 2-3 kills go through that. So, I mean, let's just check our last hits denies. This Queen of Pain is definitely winning this battle. Looks like we have some stuff going on the bottom lane. Nothing too much. This is the Clockwork doing some harassment, so nothing much going on there. But like I said earlier, this Queen of Pain definitely winning the war in terms of... Oh, and we have a gank on the mid lane. This Dragonite got a little too far out. Hit by the Frost Blast, which just definitely slows it down. And then the Enchantress with her slow, her enchant, and then just whirling axes and just took out the Dragonite. This Dragonite is having a rough time mid. This Lich, such a powerful hero now in the meta, being able to deny his own creeps and gaining experience. Not too bad. So, again, 40 last hits and 18 denies on this top lane. This Queen of Pain is just having its own fill day. I mean, even on the mid lane, this Troll Warlord is just 30 and 9, just out dueling this Dragonite. Just doing an amazing job of getting last hits and denies. Oh, he did miss those ones. Oh, the Luna with her Eclipse is able to pick off the Clockwork. I just barely caught the last of it. Wasn't able to get my camera over there in time for that. I apologize, guys, for missing that. Definitely need to work better at keeping an eye on the map. That's why it's so much nicer having a co-caster. Looks like we do have a stun here on the Troll Warlord, but nothing that they're going to be able to do about it. This throws out the stun, he gets the heal. Now the Lich comes in and throws out his Frost Blast, and then the slow, and that does it. The Whirling Axe plus the Lich Blast auto attack was able to kill the Sand King. A failed gank mid. They tried to go on this Troll Warlord, but he is just so tanky, and with those Whirling Axes, being able to have that mischance just stopped the Radiant Team Atlas from being able to do anything there. So, fortunately, that happened to just backfire on them. And apologies, guys, I forgot to fix my overlay there. Just noticed that. So, just fix that really quick. Looks like we do have a disconnect here. So, we have the Sand King that just disconnected out, so just give us a second, he'll be back in. Looking at the last hits, denies, you can see that up here. I mean, 52 on this Queen of Pain. I mean, definitely good. Looks like the Sand King is already back in. Let's just check our hero level here. I mean, 8876. Looks like everybody's good to go, everybody's back in. Gonna get this back up. Looks like this Bounty Hunter is taking some pressure from this Queen of Pain again, who, again, I have to say, has some pretty sweet wings. This Phantom Soyin has some cool wings, a cool set on this Queen of Pain. Definitely liking that. We have Eos in here on the Lich, who does have some more Dust of Appearance, so this Bounty Hunter better watch out. The Rubik has bottled up an Illusion Rune, pops it immediately. Maybe he'll be able to do something. Looks like the Dragonite did pop his ultimate, and he is now in the Elder Dragon form and does take that bottle. And I guess it is his bottle, so doing what he can. Looks like the Bounty Hunter's tired of being on the top lane, so he's going to come in and he's just going to take this creep from the Enchantress. The Enchantress did try to rotate in, maybe possibly to try to get a deny on it, but wasn't able to. So again, we have a little bit of a push on top, nothing that's going to be able to push out that lane. We have Finneth on this Clockwork, he's just kind of going along. You know, 9 minutes into the game, not much has happened. Your hero levels, 8s across the board, 8, 8, 8, 7. I mean, definitely got level 6 on this. Bounty Hunter is definitely a good thing because now they're able to. Looks like they were able to push that top tier tower with just the two of them there. This Queen of Pain just throwing out a pretty good amount of damage with this Lich. And looks like they're going to go on this Bounty Hunter. They drop the Sentry Ward and the Dust, and this Bounty Hunter is just going to melt. One last right click. Yep, one last right click from this Queen of Pain, and the Bounty Hunter goes down. That is now the third time that this Bounty Hunter is dropped to this Queen of Pain. All three kills she's gone on. She is starting a killing spree. Well, looks like here on the bottom we do have the Clockwork kind of hiding out. Not much is going to happen. We have the Sand King who's level 4 with 2 points in his Burrow Strike, so it's a little bit longer, and 2 points in Sandstorm. Looks like he is going to... No, look at that. The Clockwork just able to juke him out. Definitely must have not have been able to see him. He was just hiding in that tree right here. Pretty insane that he was able to do that, and he juked the Sand King. And now the Sand King kind of have to left to go farm, and the Clockwork's able to pick up an Invisory, and so he might be able to do something. I don't think he'd want to go on this Luna, especially with her Lunar Eclipse being, or yeah, her Eclipse being off a cooldown. She would be able to just blow that Clockwork up by just blowing her ult, trapping. If the Clockwork was to trap the Luna into the cogs, it would just be a bad idea. But now we have a Lincoln Sphere already being picked up, and we have a rotation mid. Looks like we have the Troll Warlord throwing out his Whirling Axes, and the ult from the Lich just goes out and just destroyed, and we end up seeing 4 people go down on the side of Team Atlas. Just not good. And it looks like this Luna with her movement speed is possibly, nope, the blink in from the Queen of Pain gets her in the end, and the Queen of Pain is on unstoppable streak with 6 kills there. She got 3 that time. She almost got a triple kill. We do have some teleports in, but I don't think they're going to want to go into it. The Bounty Hunter still goes into it. Oh, see? Nice. Lincoln Sphere triggers off, so she's not stunned there. We only have Team Wipe on the side of Team Atlas. Hunters is able to Team Wipe them, and nothing else has really happened. We got some backing off back and forth. Teams are being split up. Looks like the Queen of Power destroyed the tower mid, but we do still have some trading going on. But it looks like Hunters is able to back themselves out. They are able to go in and get 5 kills secured, a tower secured, and then they're able to back out. They're going to be able to reset and everything. And, you know, let's just take a quick look at the graphs here. After that little initiation, it's already 7,500 in experience, and our gold is now at 10,000. Already 10,000 gold lead. 12 minutes into the game for Team Hunters, and that is just crazy. Just looking at some of their items, we already have the urn up on the Enchantress. We have a mech already finished on the clock, and you saw the devastation that happened when they all rotated mid, and then having that mechanism just kill them up. And then you just, the Lincoln Sphere already on the Queen of Pain. We even saw that already trigger once when the Sand King tried to Burrow Strike. And then just looking at the items for the Radiant, they just don't have anything. They're already on the back foot. This is not going good for them. They're already 10 kills down, 2 towers down, and well, possibly they might be able to stop this push on the bottom here. It looks like they're grouped up as 5. Whirling Axes already go out. The Bounty Hunters come in with his track. We'll have to see what happens. Ooh, if the Sand King happened to have 2 more levels, they might be able to turn a team fight around. This Rubick as well, if could get level 6, would be really good. 15 minutes left on that. Ooh, and the Clockwork Hook just barely misses. We have the Dragon Knight blowing his ult, his Elder Dragon form. It's the poison one. He does get a stun off on the Troll Warlord. Nothing else is going to happen here. Just a small damage, but no! The Dragon Knight is slowed down by the Enchantress and then blown up by the Whirling Axes, and then the Lich just finishes him off with throwing out his auto attacks, is able to pick off the Lich here, and in the end, a 5-on-4, and they weren't able to do anything. Looks like Team Hunters is just able to just slowly siege them and was able to pick off one of Team Atlas that was out of position. Looks like they're going to lose this tower. I mean, Queen of Pain's over here. Going to take a Lucent Beam. Nope. the Luna decides to lucid beam the creep instead, just to secure it, and there you go, the bottom tower goes down. The ultimate battle trance from the troll warlord goes out and is able to pick off the tower there, and this co-op just slowly sieging down. It's got 259 health with the siege creep going. It's gonna, you know, do its damage. Pretty soon this tower will be gone, and then it'll be four towers gone for Team Atlas. There'll be four towers down. It's not in deny range. It's at 173, just enough to keep it out of deny range. We do have the Lich rotating in, and possibly maybe an engagement here. We got two on top, but still the Sand King, only level 4, is not good. He needs to get his level 6. He needs to get that epicenter. And looks like the Lich blinks in. Wow, I didn't even see that Lich was picked up a blink dagger. Looks like the Queen of Pain jumps in, not really going to be able to do anything. Good sandstorm by this Sand King, who does now reach level 5 and is able to do something. We are going to see this top tier tower, or the second tier 2 tower, fall right now. Looks like the Queen of Pain's not going to get the last hit after blinking up there. On the bottom, we have the Clockwork. He's going to just do nothing. This Elder, this Dragon Knight, threw out his Elder Dragon form again for really no real reason. No real reason to pop it, just decides to pop it. And then the Clockwork just phase boots away. Looks like they are gonna go for Roshan right now. Sorry guys, just need to get a little drink there. My mouth is going dry. And with that, Troll Warlord Trance, that Battle Trance ultimate, just the attack damage that comes out on that, they picked off Roshan. The kill score is 2-13. You can see they're gonna rotate bottom here, threw out those whirling axes, gonna kill off those creeps real quick. I mean, just your net worth right now, 9,500 gold on this Queen of Pain, who has the Lincoln Sphere, who's got boots and magic wand, and now has picked up a point booster, possibly going into an Aghanim Scepter. That would definitely make her ultimate way, way more powerful and be very great. So, I mean, Hunters is looking very much in control of this game. Going to take this tier 2 tower bottom, and now that's 5 towers to none for Team Hunters. Looks like Hunters is definitely in control, and Atlas is going down, and now this Bounty Hunter is so dead. Doesn't even matter. He just gets blown up, dusted, battle axes, and just no ults needing to be used, and just got blown up. And now they're just gonna slowly siege this tier 3 tower. I mean, they possibly get a trade off. I just don't think the Luna is able to do enough damage, and I just do not think that Atlas can withstand this 4v5 battle. And as you can see, the battle trance from the Troll Warlord, they're able to do it, and they're tanking up the tower damage, trying to keep this range creep alive until the next wave comes in. Looks like the Luna is going... No, that's not the Luna. Somebody was porting in, but decided not to, and it looks like they are going to lose this tier 3 towers. There's just nothing they can do. The lift comes out, or no, the Fade Bolt goes out on the Queen of Pain, and the Queen of Pain with her Lincoln Sphere is able to take care of that. And it's looking like there's nothing that's going to be able to do anything about it. Team Atlas is just behind bad. They just cannot fight up against this. Oh, it looks like they are going to go in on the Enchantress. It does get a good stun. Oh, and the Enchantress does go down, but all the ults come out. The Luna ult comes out, but it doesn't do anything. The Queen of Pain goes out and destroys some people. Ends up with a triple kill in the end, and it's now 4-5. 5-for-1 trade, 3 buybacks are gonna try to, Atlas is gonna try to come back into this, and then the Clockwork jumps in with an amazing hook and amazing cogs, traps 2 of them in, and the 2 more people go down. This, sorry guys, so much action. This Queen of Pain just destroys them, and GG gets called out. There's just nothing that Team Atlas can do. 18 minutes into the game, and the game is over. GG called out. You can see here from the net worth, already 15,000 experience, 20,000 gold, just got rolled over. Team Atlas just got destroyed by Team Hunters, and that goes that game. Guys, we have one last game for you for the Balt Cup. We will have the grand finals. It is going to be Hunters up against the winner out of... Let me just check and see who the other team is playing. The winner's out of Frankie and OP. So whoever wins that matchup is going to be going up against Team Atlas for the grand finals. And a chance to take home, I think it is 12 keys. I'm not 100% sure. Don't quote me on that one. Let's see... Prize pool looks like around 16 keys, possibly. That's what it's saying here. So, yeah, we will have that game coming up here. Depends on how long it takes for the other team to get done. Again, my name is Kasket. I am streaming on Kasket Dota on Twitch. Please feel free to follow me, like me. Give me comments, feedback, whatever I can do to get better at this, as this is something that I really enjoy doing. Again, thanks for watching. The Balt Cup has been great pleasure to cast these games. It has been awesome fun. I am going to drop the live stream really quick just so I can have a break, and then I can get these videos up on YouTube. And I will be casting with Mike for the next... Michael Russ for the next game, so please go to his stream. I'm going to take mine down for the time being until he gets his back up, and then I'll be joining him, and we'll be co-commentating that game. So, again, thanks again for watching. It has been my pleasure, and you guys have an enjoyable evening.